good and thick. Oh, you're gonna get a shot of that. That is a good, thick chili, just about right for a hot dog. We're gonna make some chili dogs. Now, in one of the other pictures, I'm not sure if it's going to be part of the video or not, I found some hot dogs. See, they put plastic on them here entirely. Take them off. I found some hot dogs that were just about perfect for what we use for chili dogs in the States. Little dinky fellers here. They got a really good taste, but they're not so big that they overpower the chili. And you have to remember, if you're selling chili dogs, you're selling chili. But back in America, I'm not above putting cons, big red smoky on the bottom, burying some spicy chili, some cheese. I like the jalapeno ones the best. I don't even know if they still make them. Haven't been back there in about almost 3 years. Kind of got hung up here. Anyway, we'll get the plastic off of these guys. There's two ways you can do this. You can put them on this part of the cooker like this. I don't care too much for doing that, but that would be the proper way. If you're going to use chili for something besides hot dogs, you should never put the hot dogs in the chili. But since I'm only going to use this for hot dogs, I'm going to put them in. I'm going to bury them under the chili real good. Like that. Make sure the heat is on. And then we're gonna cook. Okay. This is a cheese grater with very, very fine teeth. That's about what you want for a cheese coney. And they use these hot dog buns to put ice cream in and time in. But they're cheap. They're about, especially for a baked item, they're cheap. They're about 2 baht each or six cents a piece. We're going to open some of these up. They're not cut, so you have to cut them yourself. Now there's a big commercial bakery makes hot dog buns, but they're too long, and really they don't have any taste. I'm not going to mention them by name because maybe one day I might have to be in business with them. Oh. So we got ourselves 6 hot dog buns there. Separate them. Mmm, boy. Tender. Cut them like this. And in a minute you're going to be asking me who these guys are, and I'll tell you all about them. First, let me get these buns cut. If you're making these to sell, you need to put them in plastic and keep them kind of warm and moist. Don't have a steamer as such. Or you can keep them in the bag until you're ready to use them. I think I got them all cut there. Okay, these are all cut. There's our garbage from the hot dogs. We're getting ready to grate our cheese. Okay, about these guys. This is Chuck the Chili Dog. He's a nice little guy. He's a mild dog. He's friendly too. He won't burn your stomach or anything. He's just a little bit spicy. Not much. He's a good guy. This guy here, we have to keep him tied up. This is Prikee-Noo. His paw was a Texas chili dog, a lot of habanero and jalapeno, and his maw was a Thai hot dog, and this is why he's Prikee-Noo Pete. He's crossbreed. He's nasty. This dog will bite you back. He'll burn you from one end to the other. He even says so in our menus. Okay, these, if you're doing one of our chili kits, This is part of, as well as customized banner, personalized menus, and even a Thai translation. So you have menus for in English and menus in Thai also. This in here would be your really hot and spicy chili dog. And we call him Pete. He's a wild dog. The wild dogs get the red bandanas. Okay, see, there he is, the red bandana. Okay, this in here is Chucky. He's a mild dog. He's a nice little guy. He's good for the kids. And see, he gets the green bandana. This one here, Big Mega. This is Cincy Roy. He's Cincinnati style chili dog, but we're having a little trouble getting the Western spices here, put him together just yet. I think I'll have that problem solved next week. So we'll know. But for now, you saw me cut up all the chilies, so you know we're making a wild dog. So here we have cheddar cheese. Now I've got some pictures in Thailand. You have the yellow like we're used to. That's kind of hard to find. White cheddar is really easy. Really no difference in taste, but aesthetically, if you want a chili dog to look like what we have in America, you want the yellow cheese. Now, this time I have the white cheese. Take the cheese grater like this. And I didn't rehearse for any of this. We'll just make one real quick. Grate something really fine. Cheddar cheese. That's more than enough. If you use the small one, it melts good. It looks like you got a lot on it. Cheese here in Thailand costs about 3 times what it costs in the States. It's luxury, really. But here's how you make it easy. You take, you put your chili dog in there like, you put your chili dog bun in there like that. And you find your dog, just like that. Drop him down in the bun, like so. Take 1 spoon of the chili sauce, and this rice spoon works perfect for that. Put that on there like that. Put on your cheese. Like that. Here he is. Say hello to Pete. Say goodbye to him in about 5 minutes. We're going to fix a little oversight. Kind of forgot to show what an American chili dog with everything is. So, everything means onions and mustard. Put a little squirt of mustard down in here like that. Some people like more, some people like less. I just kind of put what we got there, whatever it was. And you put your chili dog down in there, like so. Spoon of chili, like so. Be generous. And a sprinkle of onions. On top, these are fresh cut onions. Again, some people like more, some like less. Put just some cheese on there. There we go. Now, all finished. One American chili dog with everything. But we're not going to stop there. We're going to do a three-way. Basic three-way chili. Chili. Spaghetti. Okay. Now you can can do a big label full of it, or however you want. I'm going to do it this way because I have less room to work with. I'll put about 3 or 4 scoops of this on here. Like that. Okay, now, if I put cheese on this, right now, we have a three-way. Now, if I put onions on it, and then cheese, we have a four-way. Now, this can kind of get mixed up a little bit. Now, if we put beans in the chili, this would be your beans. We put beans in the chili when we cook it. You get a five-way. Now, sometimes people say chili, spaghetti, beans, and cheese, not onions, is a four-way. Really depends. You need to, if you go into a chili parlor and you order it, or if you're making it for a customer, you need to be clear on what it is they want, or what it is that you want. So here you have four-way. Okay, for a five-way, you just put these beans in on your main. Now, there's other things you can do with chili, and onions, and cheese. If you just happen to have a baked potato laying around, it's good and hot, which, you know, I just happen to have a baked potato laying around and it's hot. Take, do this little number on it, split him open like that. And you take you some chili, put it on there, like so. Now you got a chili baked potato. Now you got a chili cheese baked potato. Maybe somebody wants onions on that too, it's up to them. So now we got a chili cheese baked potato. But wait, there's more. If you happen to have french fries laying around, which I happen to have french fries laying around, you can do the same thing with french fries. This is really good. Put that chili on there like that. And you can get you some cheese and put on top of there. Like that. Got chili cheese fries. Boy, they are good. So, a few things you can do with chili. Hope you enjoy it.